Cornell College of Veterinary Medicine and the founder of Caring Hands Animal Hospital. Although initially my goal was to start a practice within the first 5 to 6 years of graduating vet school, it has become my mission to create ownership opportunities for veterinarians. Caring Hands is a group of 8 practices in the Northern Virginia area. I have 6 partners, over 40 veterinarians, and 250 employees. I was immersed in small business from a very early age. My grandmother founded a flower shop in 1938 and raised her 5 children. I learned a lot about client service in those early formidable years. But my lifelong passion was to become a veterinarian, like many young vets out there. Lucky for me, I got accepted to Cornell College of Veterinary Medicine, and that's where I met my husband, Bob Proctor. He was studying in applied engineering and physics, getting his PhD. Once he got his doctorate, he decided to do a career change and apply to McKinsey Consulting Firm. He was offered a job from McKinsey and was placed in the Washington, D.C. office. So we packed up our bags and moved down to D.C. As he was embarking on his career as a consultant, I started scouting out areas to open my first veterinary hospital. Both Bob and I knew that if I wanted to start an animal hospital, I would have to do it early in my career because it would be a long road before that practice would become profitable. We created a business plan together, and I presented this business plan to many, many banks. They all refused to even talk to me. We were 2 30-year-olds. We had no assets to our name. He had just started his first career out of his doctorate. I had been in veterinary medicine for only 4 years. Why would they want to give us a loan for $350,000? I was lucky when I found a loan officer at Bank of America who heard my passion and my dream and offered me an SBA loan through Bank of America so that I could start my dream of owning my first veterinary hospital. In 1997, I opened the practice, just myself and 5 employees. Once I had those doors open, I didn't stop. I wasn't nervous. I was excited about this new opportunity. I was fully confident that I could create an opportunity for this practice to succeed in the Northern Virginia area. I invested in technology, I invested in equipment, and I invested in people. And I wanted to create the best practice in the Northern Virginia area for the patients and for the clients. We're in a service industry. What happens in the treatment room is just as important, but possibly it's more important what's happening in your reception area. These are the pets that you're caring for, and their clients are just as important in the service industry. So I wanted to make sure I spent just as much time empowering my reception team to do a great job, just as I did the technical team. I found what I truly loved was collaborating with my fellow colleagues. I never wanted to be a practice owner by myself. I was so thrilled that I was able to create an environment where young associates wanted to come work for me. And we would work collaborative to create that better practice with better standards of care throughout those early formidable years. After 3 years being in practice, I was pretty confident that I could do this again. And I actually started talking about doing partnerships with some of my associates. But I didn't want to do the typical partnership. I wanted to actually start more practices in the DC area. My first associate that was excited about this opportunity was Dr. Newman. We worked together for a year, and he always had a passion to want to own a practice, but never got off on his own feet. So we scouted the area and found an area in Arlington, Virginia to open our second practice together. My other associate, Dr. Murphy, who was also passionate about practice ownership, never wanted to do it on her own, and had the same talents that we had, which is striving to deliver amazing service to our patients and to our clients, asked if we could start a third practice together. So she and I started a practice in Bristow, Virginia. Over those first 10 years from starting a practice from scratch, we had developed together 4 locations and over 70 employees. We took a 5-year break from opening practices and really focused on our culture. We wanted to make sure that any client that was moving from Arlington to Centerville would still want to go to Caring Hands, that they wanted to find a practice that was in their neighborhood. And we were trying to really focus that we were doing things collaboratively together and similarly. We also focused a lot of time and attention to our brand. We wanted to make sure that we were having a presence in the Northern Virginia area. After those 5 years, it was time to start opening practices again. So the three of our associates that were interested came up to us and said, we would be interested in starting this opportunity. So Dr. Richards opened a practice in Merrifield, Dr. Streck opened a practice in Rockville, Maryland, and Dr. Canfield opened a practice in Clarendon, Virginia. All of these practices were open one after the other over a 3-year period. Then more recently, my husband and I were looking towards our future and we decided, you know, we're getting 20 years in veterinary medicine. We might someday want to have a little condo in Florida. Why not open a practice in Florida? So I scouted out some areas in Florida, found an excellent location in northern Miami, found an associate, Dr. Prentice Madden, and 1 year later, he became a practice owner. 20 years later, we're more than 250 employees. And honestly, I couldn't have done it without being part of a great team. All of my partners bring different strengths to the tables, and we do work collaboratively. And we have a shared mission, and that's creating a great environment not only for our clients and our pets, but for our teams. I know there are a lot of young associates out there that want to do practice ownership, and it's scary, but I really would encourage you to follow your dream. I never thought Caring Hands would be as big as it currently is. But if you have a dream and you continue building on that dream and you follow your passion, you can get to places you never would have thought or dreamed of. For me, it's about creating a culture of inclusion, collaboration, and opportunity. I hope you guys have a wonderful weekend and have fun. Thank you.